Get ready to match the stars. Avery Schreiber, Brett Summer, Charles Dawson Reilly, Nancy Kulp, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reber!
Dawson, how are you, John? Hello there. Oh, you got a bunch of wooers in here today.
Nice to have you with us. Come over here and say hello to these gifted and beautiful people over here. Nice to see all of your bodies. What do you mean, where?
Well,
you're one of them.
Oh, thank you.
You're the new kid on the block.
I know.
Hey,
I
listen,
feel very insecure. Has
anybody got one of the... Yeah, would you...
What?
Okay.
The
treatment for the new kid on the block is to get a little kiss on the lips.
Oh, fantastic. Turn the cameras off, will you?
No. Welcome, Nancy Kulp.
Thank you.
Nice to have you with us.
Nice to be here.
You're going to have a good time.
I think I will, yes.
I don't care what they said at the William Morris office. You're going to love this.
They won't even let me in the William Morris office.
You're lucky.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
What?
Hi, hon.
No eating on the show.
I'm not eating, sweetheart.
Charlie.
We got no lights.
Yeah, it's brighter. It's nice here. What'd you guys do?
Perky.
Oh, yeah, there's a brand new light. Look at that big square thing. We never had that before.
Beautiful gift of Loretta Young.
Where is it? All right. Thank you. Now, let's say hello to the current champ, Mr. Craig Kincaid. Got a lot of friends out there? Really? Craig has done pretty well. He's just won one game, but he's got $600. So far, he's batting 1,000. And we're going to start with the head-to-head in a moment or so and see if he can win an additional $5,000. We'll do that right after this. Here we go. Here he is, Craig Kincaid. Now, you haven't done this part of it before, have you?
At home.
Oh, at home. How are you? How do you bat at home?
I match you a lot.
You do? All right, let's have a go at it, Craig. Right. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Oh, we've done all that.
Yeah.
We're past all that.
I don't remember.
Won the $500. Why don't you say so? No, Craig's got... He's going to play now for 10 times that $500 or $5,000. I remember, you have to choose one celebrity and make an exact match to collect the amount.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's go.
Yeah, but you have to choose one.
Richard Dawson.
Oh, Richard. He's chosen you, Richard.
Okay.
All right. Here we go. It's worth $5,000. Get your ESP going over to Richard, and he gets his energy flowing back to you, and together you'll do it. Here it is. Comic blank. C-O-M-I-C blank. Okay, Craig. He is finished. Now, think carefully. Give us an answer which you think will match his answer, and you'll be richer by $5,000. Comic?
Strip.
Strip. You like that one? All right, Richard. Comic strip, he says, matches you for $5,000.
Oh, there were two.
What was the other one?
A comic book.
Comic book is
strip.
Good.
I said strip.
The girl with the yellow blouse there? Oh, that's your wife waving there. Oh, and where's your brother? Where's your brother?
Next one over.
Oh, the one with the blue shirt is your brother there.
I have to choose that because she reads the comic strips all the time.
She does. Okay, now you have a grand total of $5,600. We're going to meet another player, so let's welcome Paula Miller. Hi, Paula. How are you?
Hi, Ben.
There's a lot of excitement here because he just won a bundle of money. He got $5,600. How do you feel about money, Paula?
It would be great.
It would be great?
Sure.
Where are you from?
I'm from Detroit, Michigan. And
did you bring a large group with you?
Some.
All right, and do you, are you married, single?
I've been married for almost 15 years, and I have two boys, Matthew, 11, and Greg, who is 8.
Mm-hmm. And what does Mr. Miller do?
He's a microbiologist.
A microbiologist?
Yes.
That means a biologist who examines microscopes and keeps them healthy, is that what he does?
Right, if you say so.
If I say so. This girl doesn't even know what her husband does for a living there.
Very small man.
Good luck to you,
thank
Paula.
You.
We'll begin by asking you to make a selection. You may have A or B.
I'll take A, please.
A?
Yes.
All right. Now, we'll begin. Avery Schreiber said...
Yikes.
He said, I'll never forget the time I went out with Weird Wanda. While we were necking, she blanked my mustache. That's what happened. How are you?
I'm just wonderful. Now, let's see, Avery, I'll never forget the time I went out with Weird Wanda. While the man who called it necking was a poor judge of distance. Isn't that cute? I remember that from high school.
$5,000 number there. Craig, got this personally autographed by our star, Richard Dawson. $5,600 is what he has. Okay, we're ready down here, ready over there. And now Paula Miller. Avery Schreiber said, I'll never forget the time I went out with Weird Wanda. While we were necking, she blanked my mustache.
She, chewed on.
She what?
She chewed on.
A most repugnant idea.
I would say so.
Unless you have a mustache.
Oh, I see.
Yes, as a matter of, does your husband have a mustache?
Yes, he does.
You know?
What?
Oh!
What?
Unbelievable.
Two people with the same rotten answer between them. Okay. Chewed, it would seem, I have such a logical mind, because chewing and kissing, you know, it would just seem, if he's kissing her, how could
really?
She, I don't know.
Oh, it's easy for you to say. I think she is Weird Wanda. Weird Wanda. I don't know where I got the ING, a trimming ed.
Trimming. While we were necking, she trimmed my mustache. Yes.
Well,
They're greeting
get
you
Jules,
with a stony silence, Brett.
No. I think I'd rather be booed.
Well, just be...
No, forget it.
They do take direction, don't they?
Just be grateful for the new lights. I think it's a match, I hope so, 8.
8 and chewed, yes, indeed.
You know, and Avery...
Yeah.
Jean...
8 and chewed, yes.
And Avery never knew it.
Avery never knew it.
You know why?
Why?
It made less noise than a potato chip.
Gotcha. Okay. Now, Nancy, you're...
I chose to be more delicate.
More delicate.
Yes, I would say so.
Is this the way?
How delicate? Yes, just like
I said nibbled.
Nibbled? What about
which is
that?
A form of chew.
Thank you.
Oh, right in the slot there.
Having just kissed Avery, I just... never mind.
Now, Richard.
Very good. Nancy's first question got it right.
Right. These people, these celebrities are really making a monkey out of me. I thought she was going to strike out with that answer. And I openly said I thought it was rotten, but so far she...
Well, you never kissed Avery. There's the...
That's probably the answer.
I do not want to make a monkey out of you.
Okay.
But get a banana ready.
Now, Joyce, you're not going to let me down, are you?
Well, there's no way we could make a monkey out of you. Have you ever looked in the mirror?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Chewed. Chewed.
Chewed.
All right. Well, I've eaten a little crow there. You did very well with it. It was a terrific answer. Like I said, right from the very beginning. Splendid, my dear. Now we've got this little message for you. Pay attention and then come back. Here we go. Second half of round one. Craig, this one's all yours. And it reads as follows. Skinny Minnie is so skinny.
How skinny is he?
Let me tell you, the Jolly Green Giant picked her up and used her as a blank. That's how skinny Skinny Minnie was.
Skinny, oh, I had the most wonderful answer, sweetheart.
Really? But you can't say it, huh?
No, sure I can.
Oh, good.
Oh, it's just the bestest little answer I think I've ever had in all my life. I went to Hawaii.
When?
Last week.
Oh, no kidding. You had a lot of fun over there?
No.
No. I've never been there. I want to go there sometime.
No, you don't.
And I want to say hello to a guy who works for the newspaper in Hawaii who gave this show the greatest review ever last year.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
I went to a tiny little island and had dinner, and all those people who lived there watched Match Game.
Yes, it's very popular over there.
Yeah.
Your mother lives over there?
My mother makes them watch it.
Yes. Greg, you ready? Skinny Minnie. She's so skinny, the Jolly Green Giant picked her up and used her as a...
tongue depressor.
Oh, an original answer.
It's a doctor.
That's terrific. No, listen, that is really terrific. Now, you're really going to lose with that one, but that's terrific. Now, let me see. Everybody, Avery, what do you say?
I said it's a toothpick.
Toothpick is good. Thought of that first. Okay,
now,
let's
I would
it.
Like to ask, where does the little Jolly Green Giant live? He lives out in the woods and the trees and all and stuff and like, thank you.
Right.
And stuff and like that. She was so he used her as a blade of grass. The most wonderful answer.
Your logic escapes me. What do you say, Charles?
Because I'm losing my taste in perception?
Yes, you are.
Be thankful for the new light. Toothpick.
Toothpick. Toothpick seems to be the popular favorite, Craig. The one that's coming up most frequently and the one the audience is applauding, Nancy. What do you say?
Well, moving right along, my first thought had to do with vegetables, of course.
Yes.
And so I said he used her as a having run out of a pea pod.
A pea pod.
A pea pod.
Used her as a pea pod, isn't it?
Tongue depressor.
Don't do that. She may feel so insecure she'll never come back here. We want her to come back occasionally.
Watch it.
I think. Skinny Minnie's so skinny the Jolly Green Giant picked her up and used her as a tongue depressor.
Well, now, this is a little play on words. This is something that he used her as, and he also says, ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho. Yes, that's right. Ho, ho, ho.
No.
Yes, very clever.
The only answer I like so far.
I don't care what you say, that was a very clever answer. You leave him alone. He's a star.
Thank you.
He's got his own show and everything.
Thank you.
What do you say?
I think all these answers are awfully strange.
I have the correct answer. Ha! But it doesn't match with his either.
What is the correct answer?
Well, he does work with vegetables in the valley.
Thank you,
yes.
Thank you.
But that wasn't quite right, a pea pod. It was a string bean.
Well, string bean?
Well, there is an expression, skinny as a string bean, isn't there?
Yeah. Ho, ho, ho.
Ho, ho, ho.
You still like ho,
okay, let's go to round two. Paula, you got a choice here, A or B?
I'll try A this time. I mean,
A.
Right. B this time.
B. B. You sure?
I'm sure.
Okay. Only one person does this, and that's Brett. Are you
well,
ready,
think Mike? How embarrassed I'll be if I don't get it right twice. Why don't we let Charles play?
No. This is for you and for you alone. Sweetheart. Now listen to this.
Right.
The smart cowboy said to the dumb cowboy, he says, those cows are really a mess. What happened? And the dumb one said, well, I couldn't find the branding iron, so I branded them with a blank iron.
I got it. I think.
You got it.
Is that it, sweet?
That's it. Okay. At least fire playing, that's what I'd say. Well, one never knows about this game. Call it. Smart cowboy said to the dumb cowboy, those cows are really a mess. What happened? And the dumb one said, well, I couldn't find a branding iron, so I branded them with a blank iron.
A clothes iron. I can't think of an iron iron.
An iron iron. Judges, have you got that? She branded them with one of these. A steam iron, is that what you're saying? Okay. Okay, Brett. She says an iron iron. A clothes iron.
I like Dickie's answer. He wrote down nine iron.
A nine iron.
I wish I'd said it. There's his imagination. I don't want any arguments. Darn it all. I'm sick of it. Now, I said a steam iron, and that's an iron.
Okay. You gotta work hard. Next time, you gotta go all. You gotta go all the way to achieve a tie after this commercial. Here we go. Ready? Okay, think carefully now. Listen carefully. This is very important to Craig.
Right.
He's going to try and match every one of you and achieve a tie. Absent-minded Andy had a bad day. First, he tried to teach his front lawn to roll over, then he tried to blank his dog.
Two terrific answers.
Okay, Craig. Here we go. Absent-minded Andy had a bad day. First, he tried to teach his front lawn to roll over. Then he tried to blank his dog.
Mo.
We is looking for six Mo's over here. Give us a Mo.
Ever trim a dog? There's a Mo.
There's a Mo.
One Mo.
May I see your Mo?
You've seen my Mo.
What?
I don't know what she means.
I feel terrible because there were two great answers.
There were two great answers? Yeah, well, Mo is one, and what's the other great answer?
The other one is water. Water?
Okay, he tried to teach his front lawn to roll over, then he tried to water his dog. You got water?
No, I've got Mo.
Oh. One Mo.
She went sailing in Hawaii. Wasn't that exciting?
Mo. Okay, so far, 3 miles. You got to keep going and match everybody else. Nancy, it's up to you. Are you going
to
break the mold?
I tried to be very logical about it, and I said Mo.
Oh, you did? Yeah. Score is now 6-4. Two more Mo's, and we get a tie.
It ain't gonna rain no Mo, no Mo. Ain't gonna rain no Mo.
Now.
I guess you need me, don't you? I don't know what to tell you. There's something else you do, too, besides mowing and watering your lawn.
What's that?
You fertilize it.
Oh, you fertilize. Tried to teach his front lawn to roll over, and then he fertilized his dog. No, you can't say that.
Oh. He's dumb if you try to treat your lawn tricks, for goodness sakes. This is the same thing as mow, but it isn't how you spell it. It's cut. It's the same thing.
Well, that means we have a tie. Score is 6-6, ends up in a tie, and we've got to pull the plug and turn off all those lights and push this button here. Reveal one tie-breaking question for each. The one who matches the most will be the winner. Paula,
I'll
you
take,
at first.
I'll take A.
A.
Please.
All right, here is the tie-breaker.
Uh-oh.
The mad scientist crossed an elephant with a skunk. Now, you know what he got? Ask me what he got.
What did he get?
I'll tell you what he got. He got a skunk with a blank. The mad scientist crossed an elephant with a skunk. And you know what he got, Paula? He got a skunk with a blank. Skunk with a blank. All right. Okay, here we go with Paula Miller. Come on, Brett, stop fooling around.
Honey, I'm ready. Go right ahead, sweet.
The mad scientist crossed an elephant with a skunk. And you know what he got, Paula? A skunk with a blank.
A skunk with a trunk?
A skunk with a trunk. This audience knows good answers when they hear them, don't they? They're cheering and screaming and hollering there. What do you say?
I say he got a skunk with a voracious appetite for bananas. He got a trunk.
Skunk with a trunk. There's one trunk.
Right.
Looking for another trunk.
These little devils were in showbiz, you know.
Yeah.
So it was a... Here's my answer. Oh, there it is. It was a trunk of the vaudeville of variety.
A trunk of the vaudeville variety. All right. Here we go.
For you nature lover.
A skunk with a trunk on that. Sad. That's very artistic, though. So you've got 3 so far, Paula. You're batting 1,000, and now we come to Nancy Kulp. Mad scientist crossed elephant with a skunk, and he got a skunk with a...
I would be terrified if I hadn't written it thus.
A trunk. He's doing okay, isn't he?
Oh, good player.
What have you got there?
I was going to say a skunk with a very good memory. But I said trunk.
Skunk and a trunk. And you? Where are we? There we are. Over there. Well, we just have a few seconds to say goodbye.
I think
goodbye.
Nancy played a great day.
Nancy, you're terrific at this. Very good. Now, don't be nervous. You may be there. Join us next time.